Today's video is about understanding the differences and similarities between the FreeStyle Libre 14-day and FreeStyle Libre 2 CGM systems. That is a common question that I get all the time. Hello everyone, if you are looking for exclusive deals, blogs, educational content every week delivered to your email, subscribe to our newsletter at sugarmds.com right now. Now, how do they really work? That's another question I get a lot, right? Well, it is basically a reader. It reads. It's a sensor. It senses, right? So we call them a FreeStyle Libre CGM system. Simple. Now, the little sensor that goes right at the back of your upper arm and it detects the glucose levels, not in your blood, it detects it in something called interstitial fluid, which is a fluid found between your cells immediately under your skin. So there's nothing deep going there, nothing too invasive. You just have to simply scan the sensor with the FreeStyle Libre reader or your smartphone if your smartphone works with Libre, which we'll talk about that in a second. Now, without the need for frequent finger sticks, that is the beauty of the FreeStyle Libre sensor systems, and because it does it for you continuously. However, you still need to think that, and they're not perfect, you still have to sometimes use finger sticks to make certain decisions. If it says to you, check your blood sugar on that reader, follow that. Make sure you check your blood sugar because it may not be always accurate, especially if your symptoms do not match the readings or when you suspect the readings are not accurate for one or the other reason. Or if you feel like, hey, you feel really high but your meter doesn't say so, or if you feel too low but your meter doesn't say so, you need to check your blood sugar, okay? Now, before we talk about differences, let's talk about the similarities between the FreeStyle Libre 14-day and FreeStyle Libre 2. Now, they have a lot of things in common because they are made by the same manufacturer. Now, that makes sense, right? Now, following a list of characteristics are basically they're both continuous glucose monitoring systems, right? You know, there will be no calibration, no finger sticks required in most cases. Glucose levels are checked by the minute up to 1440 times every day. You know, that's basically the most you can get in any CGM. The sensors are fairly thin and small, and each one is around basically a quarter size, so they're not too big. And when compared to other brands, they actually have the thinnest sensors in the market right now. Now, the sensor's low profile keeps them from interfering with your daily activities, but I still see some patients knocking them off with the towel or by the doors or whatever. It happens. Now, sensors can be used up to 14 days for both, and if it doesn't last you 14 days, you just have to call the company and say, mine didn't last, send the sensors back, and they'll send you a new one, okay? They are fairly accurate, but having said that, you need to remember this fact. They will not always match your fingers to glucose readings. That is a totally different thing, so that's not apples to apples. That is because the CGMs actually measure the sugar in your interstitial fluid instead of your blood. This means that the readings may be up to 20 minutes behind, and they could be inaccurate if you have just eaten, for example, or just exercised, and your blood sugars are rapidly changing. Tissue levels will be significantly behind than the blood levels. So you just have to keep that in mind. Now, CGMs are still super cool and valuable tool for monitoring the trends, like where you're going, right? So it may be 100 right now, but are you gonna be 115 in 30 minutes, or are you gonna be 50 in 30 minutes? It helps with making decisions for your diabetes management, although it may not be that accurate, you know, when it comes to telling you what your blood sugars will be. Now, sensors, as we said, they're typically on the upper back. Some people use different body parts, but they're more accurate on the back of the arm. They're fairly resistant to the water, so some people do swimming, of course you need to shower and exercise. They're fairly resistant, and some people actually will use extra adhesive either on top of their sensor, or sometimes they will use it on their skin first and then apply the sensor, and then they will apply another adhesive. Yes, you can keep it there if you want to keep it there. Now, I know it's frustrating when they fall off and you lose them. It's like losing money. But like I said, there are these things you can do. They're available online. You can just buy FreeStyle Libre adhesives or whatever. There's something called Tegaderm. There's so many adhesives out there that you can use. There are some of them are medical grade and so forth. Yes, you can keep your sensor in place, so that's not an excuse to not to use them. Another thing you need to remember that the glucose changes are represented by trend arrows, which can be used to avoid low and high blood sugars. Now, direction of the arrows are very important because they show you how quickly your glucose is actually changing. The trend arrows can be a super helpful way to avoid the low blood sugar and high blood sugar as we just discussed. Now, if you see that your glucose is trending downwards, for example, right? You can take steps like half an hour before it actually goes low. So that is an advantage for you. Now, similarly, if you see like you ate a pizza or something and your blood sugar is already 200, if the arrows are all showing up, you know that you're gonna be 300 before you know it. So you better do something, either take a medicine or run or do something just to get the numbers down, right? It will keep you informed, and showing your trends is the most important thing with these monitors, and it helps a lot of people to keep their blood sugar in a healthy range. Now, if you wanna know more about how to deal with it, you know, you can watch my other video that I talk about that in detail, or you can actually go to the manual and then figure it out yourself as well. Let's talk about the differences between the Libre 2 and the 14 days. That's the reason for the video, but I wanted to give you information ahead of time for you to prepare for this. Now, for the time being, FreeStyle Libre 14 and FreeStyle Libre 2, unfortunately, they do not work with insulin pumps. So if you're looking for an insulin pump integration, FreeStyle Libre 14 or FreeStyle Libre 2 is not going to be your best friend, at least for now. They're coming up with FreeStyle Libre 3 that may be an option right now. They're working with Omnipod as far as I know. But Libre 2 is a little different than FreeStyle Libre 14 when it comes to the alarms. Libre 2 has the alarms and 14 day does not have that. You don't have to scan it, you know, to get the alarm. This alarm is optional though. Some people will be like not happy about the alarms because they wake up in the middle of the night and so forth, but you can adjust the alarms, when to get the alarms, and you get the alarms or not. You can turn it off, turn it on, whatever you want to do with the alarms. That is only available in FreeStyle Libre 2, and it's not available in FreeStyle Libre 14 day, which is the older system. Now, another thing that you need to know, FreeStyle Libre system has a higher level of accuracy over a 14-day period, although some patients may not agree with that, but that's what the company says. Now, FreeStyle Libre can only be the regular one. The 14-day is only indicated for adults 18 and over, but FreeStyle Libre 2 is also suitable for children age 4 and up. Now, FreeStyle Libre 2 had done a study and they were able to show that they had 1/3 fewer alarms than the competitor brand in children. Now, they also have something called Libre Link app, which allows the users to scan their sensor with their smartphone, and is not necessarily available for every FreeStyle Libre 2 user, because some Android phones and stuff like that, some people's phones may not necessarily work with FreeStyle Libre 2. So if you really want to use your phone with your FreeStyle Libre, make sure you check on their website if your phone is one of those that will be able to use the sensor. You can use your phone as a reader. You have to check that before you jump onto that. Now, if you don't have a smartphone or your phone is an old phone that's not going to work with FreeStyle Libre 2, then you may want to go for FreeStyle Libre 14 day. If your phone is a smartphone but is not compatible, then you may want to go for FreeStyle Libre 14 day if you really want to use your cell phone for that purpose. Well, that's all pretty much for the differences between FreeStyle Libre 14 day and FreeStyle Libre 2. Remember to subscribe to the channel, and remember to subscribe to our newsletter by visiting sugarmds.com. You're going to get exclusive deals. You're going to have weekly newsletter from us, and we think you will love it. Hey guys, I hope you're enjoying this channel so far, and I hope you subscribed already. If you didn't, do it. And if you did, watch this video right there. I think that will help you too.